Now, I want to focus on how we can cater for mentally impaired and hearing impaired persons in matters of transport. Now, mentally impaired persons are basically persons that have challenges in their mind. Maybe they had an injury in their brain and thus their brain is not able to function well. Maybe they were born that way, their children that are born with a mental disability. Hearing impaired persons are persons that are not able to hear. Sometimes you call them deaf people. So deaf are also sometimes called hearing impaired people. And since they are people, we have to cater them for matters of transport. And I want to combine these two, the hearing impaired persons and the hearing impaired persons and the mentally impaired persons, and how we can cater for them in matters of transport in my presentation. Now, as I've just said, mentally impaired persons are persons whose brains have some form of handicap. They are not able to reason normal. They are not able to make the right judgments. And since they are people, they have to be taken care of. They have to be catered for in matters of transport. Hearing impaired people are sometimes called deaf people, meaning they are normal, but they have a disability in their hearing sense. They are not able to hear voices. They are not able to hear sound. They are not able to hear anything because they are deaf in their ears. And since they are people, we need to think about how we can cater for them in matters of transport. And as I've just said, I'm going to combine these two in my presentation, and then we shall move on to something else in my next presentation. Now, how can we cater for mentally handicapped and hearing handicapped or impaired persons in transport? Number one, for mentally handicapped persons, they should have a guide or an assistant. A guide or assistant to cater for them or to be with them as they are moving from one place to another. So for the hearing impaired and for the mentally impaired persons, as they are moving from one place to another, when they have to move from one place to another, they must have a guide, they must have an assistant to monitor them and to be with them as they are moving from one place to another. And that is a very important way of catering for them in matters of transport. Number two, another way we can cater for these two groups of people in matters of transport is that all road users must be very alert. The moment they see a person and the way that person is behaving or reacting on the road seems abnormal, they need to be very, very careful, because this person may actually either be mentally impaired or hearing impaired. So motorists, being careful, being very observant, being very keen as they are using the roads can be termed as another way the mentally handicapped and the hearing impaired persons can be catered for in matters of transport. Number three way we can cater for these two groups of people is awareness. Awareness. Schools, learning institutions such as schools, churches, and other places of worship, NGOs, the media, should come up with awareness campaigns that we have these people within our communities, and teachers create awareness to us on how we can cater for them, how we can identify them, and how we can cater for them in matters of transport. So awareness creation, making people aware that not everybody on the road is hearing, not everybody that is crossing a road is stable in his mind, and how we can cater for such persons can be termed as another way we can cater for such persons in matters of transport. So three things that we need to remind ourselves: we have people that are mentally impaired, meaning they have some disability in their reasoning, in their minds. Maybe they were born like that, maybe they had an accident that affected their brain. We have those that are not able to hear, we call them hearing impaired people. How can we cater for them? Number one, when they are moving from one place to another, they should ensure, or people should ensure, that they are responsible enough to offer a guide or to guide and assist them when they are moving from one place to another. Number two way we can cater for such persons is that all road users must be very careful, drivers must be very careful, pilots must be very careful, everybody that is in the transport industry must be very careful when they are using the various modern forms of transport. And the moment they realize that this person is not able to hear, this person is not able to reason well because he has some mental challenges, they are able now to be cautious, and thus that by itself can be termed as another way of catering for such people in matters of transport. Number three, awareness campaigns should be emphasized and encouraged by the government, schools and learning institutions, media, institutions that deal with communities and people must come up with very good awareness programs to create how we can identify such people and the roles we can play in matters of catering for them in matters of transport. So awareness campaigns to teach us, to demonstrate to us, to create awareness, to emphasize to us how we can cater for them should be encouraged. And those are three very special ways, three very good ways we can cater for such people in matters of transport. I hope you've learned something. See you in my next presentation. Thank